of whether smartphones are hurting students' ability to learn. Some experts worry it might mean we're losing important skills and abilities. 12 News' Kent Wainscott investigates.
I'm absolutely reliant on my phone.
When they want to know something, they know I ask Siri.
Siri here.
You know, she's buried in her phone or buried in her device.
Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook.
But have you lost any skills because of it?
Don't learn how to interact with other people.
I think I can do things that the old people could do.
Your smartphone is now also your camera, compass, clock, and dozens of other things you used to use and rely on.
How may I help you?
But is it doing too much for us?
And there's only so much that Siri can tell us. She isn't all-knowing, despite what my kids think.
Marquette professor Melissa Gibson thinks the digital revolution is also creating a sort of digital evolution, changing what and how we learn.
Our access to technology at any moment has changed the way we know things.
But are young people losing certain important skills because their phones are doing the work for them?
You've lost skills.
Oh, yeah.
For example.
I think my attention span is so much shorter because of my phone.
Are we relying on our phones for too much?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I think we're losing a lot of basic skills.
Who right now could tell me their home phone number?
I can. I don't have a home phone.
You don't know your own address?
No, I don't.
We asked these Shorewood High School students to help us with an experiment, solving an everyday problem.
You need to get from here to 5300 South Howell Avenue. What would you do?
You know,
Google Maps.
Yeah, just plug it into Google Maps and navigate from there.
Navigate one simple route and find out where it takes you.
South Howell.
Howell?
Where's Howell?
First, using their phones.
I don't know what it is. Someone figure it out.
Oh, my phone died. I would never get there.
And then doing it the way their parents and grandparents did.
You ever see one of those?
Oh, it's a map.
They discovered the answer.
Oh, it's the airport. General Mitchell Airport.
And discovered something about themselves.
I would be lost, and all I have is technology, and I'm completely reliant on technology.
But it also raised an important question.
So I wonder if the development of technology is preventing us from gaining brain power.
Any part of the brain that doesn't get a workout tends to kind of deteriorate.
Nationally recognized authority Dr. Nora Newcombe says there are trade-offs with the increase in smartphone use among young people.
With any technological revolution, I think you don't know what you're gaining and losing. You can be confident that you're doing some of each. And more importantly, that you're changing, you know, and so life is going to be different.
But she says losing skills once considered essential,
like when people turn butter, I wonder, like,
doesn't mean we lose the ability to still learn them.
Okay, I found this on the web for how to churn butter.
So in the end, the experts say it's less about the skills we're gaining or losing.
Are you worried at all about where this is headed?
I mostly remain hopeful about where it's all headed.
Then about how the way we learn is changing.
I wonder what kids in the future will be like, wow, all you had was that iPhone. What do you even do with that little box in your pocket?
So while young people may be losing skills like handwriting or the ability to balance a checkbook or make change, they're replacing those with other technology-related skills.
But are they losing things that can't be replaced?
Well, there are some studies that suggest that too much reliance on digital devices could be hurting things like memory or the ability to recognize emotion in facial expressions. Those are some of the concerns that researchers have.
Impacts so many of us.
Right.
Fascinating look. Kent, thank you.